Like, I don't know. I tell you, I underestimated how long both the CLDC and the VLDC would take to complete. And C3 is coming up, and I can only imagine that people are gonna ask me to play their ROM hacks that they submit there. Or just check out what they submit. So yes, I'm aware that C3 is coming up in less than a week, and if you've got anything cool, submit it there. Chances are I might be playing it, but not likely. I'm actually going to be away for some of the weekend, so I figured I'll just play as much CLDC entries and VLDC entries as I can, so that a bunch of that is done for when C3 comes around, so that I'll have more time to just play what you send there. So now we're playing the SpongeBob Man's Chocolate Level Design Contest 2016 entry. Yoshi Berry Orchard. Wow. Look at all the U's in the status bar! Welcome to Yoshi Berry Orchard. Here you can find many berries. You might even find Yoshi in this. The SpongeBob Man, yep. So I decided to actually play the first half of this level off camera, because I was curious to see what this guy did. I mean, I've already seen his Green Meadows level. I mean, it wasn't really that bad, he was just severely late to the contest. And from what I heard, he also used ASM to remap the position of the stem on the piranha plant, which is against the VLDC rules. Even if it's just to move the location of a graphic, that's still technically part of the game. Well, part of the original Super Mario World, it's still technically against the rules. Like, honestly, didn't even notice that. So if you saw that weird black square when you saw me play Green Meadows, that's the reason. The ASM he used to just remap the position of the stem wasn't copied over, so that's why it's a black square. A lot of berries. Imagine if we find Yoshi. Like, not really, like, I need any more extra time anyway. But still, imagine if we found Yoshi now. Invisible plot, of course. Okay, so we fixed the bug where if you're hitting a question block with a coin above it, then you can actually stand on the tile where the coin was. Down. And I just fell in the hole and died. Maybe you shouldn't put that little hole there, but maybe I was just really unlucky. I mean, this level honestly feels like he took every tile set he could figure out whether or not it existed. Like, this level just looks like the author took literally every tile set that ever existed and put them all in one level. Said, hey, fuck it. I can't decide which tile set I want to use, so let's use all of them. A bunch of these tile sets are related to one another. I mean, we got the grass tile set, the forest tile set, trees, plastic blocks you can find in the grassland. They're all related, but it just looks like such a... What's the word I'm looking for? Alright, clusterfuck. Okay, we have this colored forest ground, and then we have, like, dark brown forest ground, then we have the woodland from Super Mario Bros. 3, and then we have the grass from Super Mario World that's green. Look at all the different tile sets that are being used in this one level. Never seen anything like this. Maybe because it's a bad idea. Maybe because it's just overwhelming for people to look at stuff like that, and the blue block lets you finish the level. What did the message block say, though? I don't know if the level has another exit. And if it does, someone can tell me in the comments section. Yay, we get to play another level from Yoshi9429. The guy who made New Mario's Adventure that I played, like, half a year ago. Mario found a castle. He was curious and decided to go inside. Will he be able to escape? Extreme Castle. Yep, this is it. This is his level. Oh, hey, it's Happy Nimona! Another great song by Think One More Time that he wrote. I mean, if you like this, you can also check out Styla. This definitely feels like a level he would make. I can tell by all the ceilings and whatnot. And these Venus fire traps as well. This is definitely something he would have done. I mean, New Mario's Adventure was a pretty big hack for a demo, and I got a pretty good taste of what this guy's level design style is as a result. So it kind of feels like I'm replaying a bunch of past hacks all over again. Which is pretty damn cool, considering some of them were pretty nice. I mean, I said earlier that I felt like I was playing something out of Jump earlier. And then I played Darken's Alien Hive, which felt a lot like something I'd have seen out of Oninja Negro. Hack that Darken made. And now I'm playing something that feels like it would have come out of New Mario's Adventure. So yeah, it's like a nice trip back to the past. If 6 months ago was really, like, that far back to be considered the past. Oh man, this is a nice background. I wonder where you found it. And I'm pretty sure it's layer 3, because the spikes are on layer 2, I can only imagine. Yup. Knew it. Once you play enough Super Mario World hacks, you'll know pretty much how everything is constructed, almost. That is pretty good for layer 3, considering you're restricted to, like, 3 colors plus the transparency. That is really good for layer 3, considering how you're restricted in terms of colors.
Yep. Okay, this looks new.
how do I... Okay. It's not entirely new. It's a homing swamp, but... Okay, could I just technically stand here? Okay, maybe not. I was thinking maybe I could just stand here and do, like, absolutely nothing, and then just wait for the bombs to explode and kill this thing. But I guess not. Can I get this flower, or is that not- It's not possible to get this thing, because of how the level is built. It will always fall down the middle of the screen, yet you can never actually go to the middle of the screen, because of how this level's set up. I mean, going through the pipe technically doesn't count as actually being in the middle of the screen to pick up the power-up. So you pretty much lose it. This was a really interesting way to set up the homing swamp boss, like... I mean, I always like to see someone do something unique with this because of how overused it is. I mean, this is probably gonna be annoying as hell just to... Okay, now I think we're on the right track. Just hope I don't run the timer out. Around is gonna be a bitch because this thing just lands every second or so. There we go. Now I just wait for that to blow up or we're done the level. Wait, what? Okay, the level's not ending like it should. The sprites are all gone. The swamp's dead. The level doesn't end properly. We didn't get a course clear screen. So I think I'm stuck here. Well, looks like that's the end of this level. It's as far as I can get without just getting stuck. So we're gonna call that the end of the level. I mean, the boss is dead anyway. Get ready. I am really excited to see what... Aloysius. I think it's pronounced Aloysius, I'm not 100% sure. I am really excited to see what this guy has done for this contest. Yes, this is a hack he's working on, and apparently he decided to take one of its levels and just send it to the contest, I guess? Mario World Super, real original creative title. I'm being sarcastic, of course, if you can tell by the tone of my voice. I mean, the hack itself looks way more creative than you think. Just by looking at the title. He literally just reordered the words of the original game's title, and that was it. Planning an attack, yada yada. Sunset Vista. Because I've actually seen this level in the works in progress. Okay, you can't spin jump in this game. This guy has a Works in Progress thread on Super Mario Central where he's showcasing screenshots from this ROM hack of his he's working on, and this was one of the levels that he's built for it. And for some reason, he decided to send it into the contest. As you can already tell, it looks really nice, sure. And there's spikes that protrude out of the ground. If you look at the blocks closely enough, you'll see little holes in them. That's a really good clue that spikes are gonna pop out of there. Oh wait, we get a hammer suit? And a boomerang suit. It looks so much like the hammer suit, so I just thought it instinctively. And yes, this guy's putting in custom power-ups from what I can tell. Considering how slow progress has gone on this hack though, I'm not imagining a full release anytime soon. I mean, if it was, I would totally play it. I mean, I still love the attention to detail on pretty much almost every aspect of this level. You can see grass growing on the ruins of this temple. It looks amazing. Oh, wow. Okay, I could just stand here and not have to worry about the spikes. I'll just wait for them to retract again. And that's all for our dragon coin. Okay, so far this has to be one of my favorite levels in the entire contest. I mean, it still feels a lot like the original Super Mario World and even looks like it, but it also feels very original and just different too. From a hack called Mario Sakura, you're not expecting much. But this goes way past what I'd be expecting from a hack called that. I mean, you really do want to go slowly, because those holes on the blocks that do have them, where the spikes come out, are actually very barely noticeable at all. See the spikes for a second when you're standing on them, and then they'll pop out and then they can hurt you. Only when they're fully protruded from the ground can they actually hurt you. And how do I get this midpoint? Where'd that spike top go? It just disappeared. I'm not making this up. I'm just gonna leave the midpoint behind. I don't even know how to reach it. What if someone who's not so good at Super Mario World really needs that midpoint? What are they supposed to do? I mean, I could probably easily beat this one. Oh! Okay, now it all makes sense. You just have to get a springboard. And then use it here, and then you get the midpoint. Now we're inside the temple. Whoa, look at those spikes! Look at that! That's amazing! This is amazing. Look at this. I hope this guy wins. If he doesn't, then whoever beats him... Holy crap, I can only imagine whoever can beat this guy, what they do. Now are they... Okay, these spikes are moving the other way. Okay, they're still moving in a wave-like fashion, but they're moving... Holy crap. The attention to detail here is just something else entirely. I mean, what else can you expect from Mines, the guy who won the 2010 Vanilla Level Design Contest with Forever Factory? And here I am falling in the hole. Wait, I seriously had that little time left? So what's to the right? Probably just, yep, power up. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna want that just in case. It's not like I'm going out of my way to try, like, throw a shell somewhere to hit a block to go and get a power up. It's not like I'm just waiting for a Koopa to get in this shell so I can get a simple mushroom. It's definitely easier to move left when the spikes are moving left. I have to set something like this up for one of my own hacks. Well, I almost don't care that I'm gonna get wrecked by those spikes, because of how amazing this looks overall. I almost don't care if I get a game over. Maybe that will work. Now I want to see what's up ahead of me. I also don't know how much time I have to stand on these platforms before the spikes come out and, like, just hurt me. got even less room to just stand around, so I really gotta be careful with all my okay, just get away from this ball and chain, because that could have just killed me right there. A few pixels to the right and I'd have been dead right there. Just trying to look at the spikes and figure out what's the best way to approach them. Okay. Oh, now there's enemies. And of course, I'm just gonna jump right into this one. Okay, and I've kept both power-ups, and I actually forgot that to the right of me, when I entered the second half, there was a power-up, so I just kept trying this without the extra power-up, which would have helped a lot. Uh-oh, hopefully I can just post-hit invincibility run through this. Not that much more level up there. Holy crap. This is just one giant marathon of spike dodging. To redo the first half, but like that's way easier. I mean, the spikes have a pattern, so if you can get used to that, then you shouldn't have too much trouble, really. I mean, still gotta dodge all the other crap, but I mean, it's just really fun trying to get the pattern down, and if you can, then you will feel really good about yourself, because you will have done something pretty damn tricky. Okay, there's still more level where that came from. Wonder how long it took for him to set up all these spikes. They're synced up so beautifully. Wonder how long this took to actually sync up properly. Just get some coins, and we're pretty much done the level. But what's to the right? Just a coin. And we're done the level! Probably one of my favorite levels in the contest so far, next to Motel from Frozen Quills. I mean, it's pretty damn tricky to get the pattern down on the spikes in the second half, particularly when there's all these enemies to dodge.